Hello friends, I'm Guna Madhivanan, current affairs faculty at Officers IAS Academy. As I said, I'm coming up with the current affairs hit list video series in which I'll be discussing one video in every day. So we started with the MSP. So today we will be moving on to the next topic, that is Indian Ocean Commission. Why Indian Ocean Commission becomes important for our preliminary exam? Because recently India has been accepted as the observer in Indian Ocean Commission. Okay, so we will see about Indian Ocean Commission first. So Indian Ocean Commission, it is an intergovernmental body which has 5 countries as members: Seychelles, Comoros, Madagascar, Mauritius, as well as France, Reunion Island. So it is an intergovernmental body which was created in the year 1984. In 1984 it was created, right? It has 5 members. So recently India has been accepted as the observer. Now let's try to understand the objective of this Indian Ocean Commission. So why these 5 members, they formed a grouping? So their objective is to protect their unique human, cultural and natural diversity. They want to protect their, or they want to promote, protect the uniqueness in terms of human, cultural as well as natural diversity. And these Indian Ocean countries, they are facing unconventional challenges nowadays, so they want to pool their resources so that they can collectively face to those challenges. So these are the objectives for forming this Indian Ocean Commission in 1984. So now how this is going to be significant for India? India, by becoming an observer of Indian Ocean Commission, in what way it is going to be beneficial for India? For which you have to understand another topic which is called as Information Fusion Center. Information Fusion Center. So what is this Information Fusion Center? So Information Fusion Center, Indian Ocean Region. Information Fusion Center, Indian Ocean Region. We know that India has roughly 7,500 kilometers of coastline. I also take the islands into consideration. Okay, mainland plus islands. So we have a coastline of close to 7,500 plus kilometers roughly. So we have a strong radar system which we have placed in our coasts. So in every coastal point, the coastal border, we have placed some radar. So that radar will be watching what is happening in the Indian Ocean region. It's in all the coastal districts, the coastal areas, there will be radars which will be watching, okay, what is happening in the Indian Ocean region. Now 7,500 kilometers of coastline, right? So many radars will be there, right? It will be collecting more information, right? All those information will be collated, all those information will be brought together in a one particular place. That is called as Information Fusion Center for Indian Ocean Region. That Information Fusion Center, that center is located in Gurugram, Haryana. It is under the Navy control. So they watch what is happening in the Indian Ocean region with the help of coastal radars which we have placed in our 7,500 kilometers of border, coastline border. All right. So this is very important to have a maritime domain awareness. To have a maritime domain awareness, we should have a strong coastal radar system, and we have. Now, let us try to connect this with Indian Ocean Commission. Now, why I am explaining about Information Fusion Center? Like how we have an Information Fusion Center, these Indian Ocean Commission countries, these 5 countries, they also have a Information Fusion Center, which is called as RMIFC. Regional Maritime Information Fusion Center. The 5 Indian Ocean countries, island countries, Madagascar, Seychelles, Mauritius, Comoros, Reunion Islands. So these countries, right, these 5 countries, they have an Information Fusion Center. They have an Information Fusion Center in Madagascar. Okay, so like how we are having radars in the coastal borders, like that, the island countries, they also have in their country, in their coastline, they will be having radar system. So with the help of the radar system, they will be having some awareness in that Indian Ocean region. Let's say, look at this map, friends. assume that with the help of our coastal radar system, assume we are having an idea of what is happening in this region. Okay, assume that all these regions we are able to watch what is happening. Now, these five countries, they have their coastal radar system with which assume that they are able to see what is happening in this region. Our fusion center is located in Gurugram, Haryana, and their fusion center is located in Madagascar. So now we becoming an observer of this Indian Ocean Commission, now we can take the efforts to link both the fusion centers. So both the information fusion centers now can be linked. We can share our information to them. They will be sharing their information to us, so that we will be having. So what is the advantage for India? So through our radar system, assume that we are having awareness on what is going on here. Through these Indian Ocean Commission's radar system, we are able to know what is going on here. So effectively, we are able to have a stronger observation, a stronger maritime domain awareness in Indian Ocean region. That is the greatest implication of we becoming an observer in Indian Ocean Commission. So we are also planning to send a Navy liaison officer for this purpose, to make use of the data from both the fusion centers, right? So this is about Indian Ocean Commission and the Information Fusion Center. I have discussed two topics under a single heading, right? I hope the video was useful. I hope the initiative is also useful. So I have asked a question based on whatever we have discussed. You try to find the correct answer and give your correct answer in the comment section. If you like this initiative, you can give your feedback in the comment section as well, right? Thank you, friends. We'll see you in another video. Thank you.